Hi guys, welcome to the full camera review of the Samsung Galaxy A52s 5G. At first I decided to skip the full camera review of the smartphone, but many of you were asking me in the comment section of my other videos that I should be doing this camera review. So here it is. This is a front 1080p at 30 frames per second video from the front camera, and you have to judge the colors, resolution and the voice recording quality of this phone's camera. This is, as usual, is going to be an in-depth camera review. So let me switch to the other camera resolutions now. We are now looking at 1080p at 60 frames per second video recording from the front camera of the A52s 5G. Stability is going to get a little hurt here, but I think it's still going to be fine because I am recording on a single phone. It's handheld and I am walking to give you guys an idea about the stability. And you can take a look around. Let's switch to the 4K resolution now. Now this is 4K at 30 frames per second from the front camera of the A52s 5G. After this, you are going to take a look at the features in the camera application, just a walkthrough of the camera application, and then we'll start with my own ultra wide images from this phone's camera. Let me show you around in this resolution as well. As you can see that it's a very bright sunny day with a lot of light, and it's a little bit hot too. Let's move on to the other parts of this camera review. Let's get the camera sensor details out of the way. The main sensor is a 64 megapixels, and rest of the details including the Sony IMX682 sensor are up on the screen. Let me quickly show you the camera app. There's nothing extraordinary or different here than the A72 and the A52. This is the exact same camera app with all the basic features, including slow-mo, super slow-mo, portrait mode, video recording modes up to 4K at 30 frames per second from both the front and the rear cameras. Pro mode still doesn't have the RAW option. It should have been there since this phone has a better Snapdragon 778 chipset, which brings a better ISP. The rear camera videos in the 1080p at 30 frames per second ultra-wide mode are up. In the 1080p at 30 frames per second video recording mode, the stability of the phone is good. Resolution is also good, but I would like slightly deeper colors, a little bit of added saturation here. In the 60 frames per second video mode, the stabilization is horrible. I understand that the A52 was a pure value for money product, and Samsung compromised on a lot of things on that phone, including the video stability, but they should have improved it on the A52s 5G. This one is 4K at 30 frames per second video in the ultra wide mode, and then you will see it in the normal mode too. In the 4K mode, the stabilization is not as good as 1080p at 30 frames per second mode. Otherwise, it's a fine video. I guess you are always going to need a gimbal to record videos on this phone. Let's take a look at the rear camera photo samples now, starting off with the ultra-wide image. Samsung's ultra-wide cameras have always been good, be it their mid-range phone or the flagship phone. I am not talking about the low-end phones. This image lacks a little bit of saturation, but overall it's pretty good, and I am sure you are not expecting a lot of details in the ultra-wide image. Saturation comes back all of a sudden in the normal mode. Here the dynamic range is quite good, shadows are balanced, and details are fine. In the high-res mode, the details take a whole new level, but here we can see a little bit of depth effect in the background. This image also has slightly higher saturation. This one is now the portrait, and it is self-explanatory. I think this phone is doing a pretty good job here. Now all these images side by side, you can see that the colors of the ultra-wide image are not that deep. Just like I said before, the contrast is a little low here. The 64 megapixels image has highest details. The normal image has everything well balanced, from the dynamic range to the shadows, highlights and saturation. The portrait mode image has boosted the reds. Another set of ultra-wide, normal and the 64 megapixels image along with the portrait images on the screen, you can clearly spot the same differences once again. The A52s does a pretty good job when it comes to capturing human subjects from all of its camera modes and lenses. I don't think that this result is too different from the result of the A52 and the A72, and those phones also had pretty good camera result. Let me show you some more ultra-wide, normal and high-res images. If you want the best overall picture, I'll suggest sticking to the normal 3:4 camera mode of your phone. Using the high resolution is recommended only when you have to capture landscapes and you need crop-in capability. Otherwise, the normal camera with slightly less details does an excellent job, and ultra-wide camera is doing fine too. While reviewing this phone right now, I have its price tag in my mind and I have a great idea of what to expect, which is why I am finding its result good. If I start expecting flagship results from this camera, I won't be liking it anymore. For the day-to-day photography usage, this is more than sufficient. Take a look at some more ultra-wide and normal images now. I think these camera samples are good enough to give you an appropriate idea of the Galaxy A52s's camera capabilities. Now I'll show you a number of rear camera images. These are going to be in different colors, and these images are mostly shot in broad daylight, and there are some indoor images on your way too. What I want you guys to do is, I want you to watch all these images closely, pause whenever you want, and analyze these images on your own, and make sure that you drop your own analysis and thoughts down in the comment section below. I'll catch you guys in a bit with the low light and the night mode images. In the night mode, the A52s isn't a great performer. I mean, it's still better than its Android competitors, but recently I compared the A52s to the iPhone 13 and I found out how far the phone was in terms of the camera result. The night mode needs to be polished. It needs better noise management, and this camera shouldn't blow off lights in the night mode at times. Despite all this, this night mode is still better than 90% other mid-range Android devices, and for that reason I would still prefer this one. Take a look at the selfies now. Selfies are in both the wide and the close angle, and in both the normal and the portrait modes. The depth effect in the selfies is also good. Details are quite high. As you can see, the selfies in my opinion lack a little bit of saturation. Samsung could make these selfies more vibrant. The color tone in the selfies is natural, it's cool, and it's not bad. But there is room for improvement in terms of colors and contrast of the selfies. Let me know what do you guys think. Do you prefer selfies taken on this phone, or you like more beautified or more saturated selfies with deeper colors? And with this, our Galaxy A52s 5G camera review comes to an end. The verdict regarding this phone is not an easy one, because it's an upgraded A52, basically an A52 with a new processor, and it comes with a different and higher price tag. It's really difficult to recommend it. I am already working on the Galaxy A52s versus A52 camera comparison, and I can tell you right now that the camera result is similar on both the sides for the most part. If your concern is not just the camera and you also want a better CPU, you may go with the A52s 5G. It's not a bad phone when it comes to performance. If your concern is just the camera, I think you can get the same result from the A52, and there is no need for spending all that extra money on the A52s 5G. The rest is your own choice, and I would love to hear you guys out. Make sure to drop your own feedback down in the comment section below, hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't yet. With that being said, I will sign off and see you all in the next one.